I'm Jill Friedkin. I am playing Sarah and Molly.
My name is Michi Burrell, and I'm playing Emily.
So, my name is Brian Haskins, and I'm new to the show, but I'm playing Gabriel and Alex.
Hi, I'm Jessica Almasi. I'm so excited to be playing the roles of Jess and Amy.
Hi, my name is Scott Barrow, and I am playing Dan.
So my name is Andrew Duff, and I play the character of Moose.
Hi, my name is Oberon K. Ejipom. It's actually Oberon Kodjoa Samwa Ejipom. I play the character of Jake.
Hi, I'm Porva Bailey. I'm playing two characters, Ajla and Libby. And Ajla is a mom with a daughter who is on the autism spectrum, and she's from India.
Sarah is the love interest of Dan, who is a man on the spectrum, and she is not officially on the spectrum, and she is a person that is really, she's really open-minded and eager towards the world.
The best part about playing Dan is his pendulum swings just completely from side to side. He is so unbelievably brilliant about something. And then you have the same character who is just misses the boat a little bit when it comes to say things like, social interaction or miscommunications with this woman.
Emily is the mother of a nonverbal autistic boy, man, as he grows up in the show. And I guess like a lot of moms, she is a warrior.
Gabriel's somebody who just wants to be a good, stable father and provide safety and security. And when you have that much guesswork to do in your life, how's the day gonna go? What's the surprise of the day gonna be? And it can be so exhausting, and it's quite a challenge.
Jess is a woman really introspective, can be quite moody, guarded, really into the brain. And the other role, Amy, is a therapist who works with people identified on the autism spectrum in order to help them both assess and improve what their access is to language and to being able to communicate and articulate just neurologically and physically.
I've been playing Moose on and off for the past almost 4 years now in workshops, and so it's a role that's very near and dear to my heart, and he's nonverbal. He has a little bit of echolalia, which means he repeats some things. He just loves life. He loves water. He loves sensory stuff. And I think this play, more than any other media portrayal, really explores the spectrum as a whole. So I think no matter what your perspective is on autism, whether you know somebody, whether you're on the spectrum yourself, whether you're a doctor, a parent, a sibling, you're going to learn something new.
To me, I think he kind of brings the play together in a whole full swing of things, because he lets you know that there's an actual spectrum in autism. The character that he's actually with in the scene, he expresses himself as normal. I guess that is common. And the whole play being uncommon, it kind of puts everything in full swing with that.